Welcome to this overview of ScanPayGo. So, first of all, let's imagine that I am downloading the app for the first time. I press the app and open it up. I get this welcome screen that explains the app in three easy screens. When I'm done reading the information, I get routed to the main screen. And the first screen is the shopping screen. There, I get a screen telling me that I need to be closer to the store so I can open the screen and start scanning in items. I have to be inside the 250 meters of the store so I can start scanning in items. The next tab is the item screen, where I can navigate through all the item hierarchy and take a look at the products and see more information about them. The hierarchy is completely controlled inside Business Central, and you can group together items like you want. The next tab is the More tab, where you get the option to log in, look at the general offers, or get the location of the stores. So I'll start by opening the offers. Here you can see two general offers. But if you were logged in as a user, you could see some customized offer to this specific user. Next, we have the store screen that gives you a map of the stores, and you can find a list of all your stores in an ordered list from the nearest to the furthest away. And if you click one, you get routed on the location of your store, and pressing the red bubble gives you a pop-up with opening hours. And if you press the Go button, you get navigated into Google Maps or Apple Maps. But now I'm gonna log in as a user. When I have logged in as a user, there's an extra tab that shows up. This tab is your shopping list. There I can add in a shopping list and items into the list by either scanning the barcode of the products or manually adding the items to the list. I can then use my shopping list when I'm inside the store shopping. Now, if I click the More tab again, I can see that two extra buttons have appeared. That is the Purchase History screen and the Personal Information screen. In the Purchase History screen, I can navigate through all my shopping history. I can open it up and see what items I have shopped. I can select some items and move them to my shopping list if I want. Like here, I moved the mouthwash over to my shopping list. Now, if I open up the shopping list, you can see here that the mouthwash got added to the list. Now, if I open up the first tab again, you can see that I can start scanning now in items. That means that I'm inside 250 meters of the store. If I press start scanning, my basket screen will appear where I can scan in items. I can look up items and see my shopping list all in the same screen. If I select my shopping list, I can see all the items that are inside the list. And if you look at the soap here inside the list, and if I press scan button and scan in that soap, it will disappear from my shopping list. You can also manually add items to the list by searching for them and adding it to the list. When I'm done adding in all the things that were on my list, I'm going to add the toilet paper as well, because it was a great offer that I saw. And now if I refresh the screen, you can see that the discount was added to the item. Now, to the payment part. You can control what options you see here on this screen, what payment methods you want to use. Pay at POS, pay inside app, or pay with loyalty points. If you press pay with loyalty points, you will get a pop-up if you don't have enough points. What else, it will finish the sale for you. If you press pay at POS, you will get a QR code that the staff member on a POS will scan in and transfer your order to the POS. But if you press pay inside app, you will have to put in your credit card information and finish the sale. If you select to save the card, the next time you will pay, you will get routed straight to the Pay Inside app screen, and you can pay with the last used credit card. Thank you for watching this overview.